With David, of course, it's Susie Dent.
Yay!
In David's most recent book, he named a squirrel after Susie Dent. Small, wild, and with an insatiable appetite for nuts, Susie was delighted.
I was really happy when he told me I was a character in his book. And then the squirrel bit came and I thought, well, OK, but apparently I'm a thief and a credit card thief.
Yeah, Susie helps me with... I write children's books and Susie knows the correct way to spell meow and words like that. And then to thank her, I made her into a criminal squirrel in the new book. Yeah, that's...
Aww.
That's the time she met Joe.
Susie regularly gives talks on lexicography where members of the public get to ask insightful questions such as, how long is this going to go on for and do I have to stay? Susie, you're a wordsmith. If you chose one word to describe me, what would it be?
Gosh, so many choices. Whittling. Somebody who thinks he's funny but is not.
Susie, it says here your least favourite word is moist. What's your favourite word?
Favourite? Oh, the one I thought of today, probably because I was coming to see you, was testiculating.
Thank you.
There's so many words that women have come up with recently to take a sort of subtle revenge, and they're just quite cheeky. Mansplaining I don't like. I think that's just a bit clumsy. But testiculating is when a man talks bollocks.
Testiculating? Good work. If you want to know how exciting Susie Dent is, let me paint you a picture and then watch the paint dry. That's how exciting she is. Susie, have you got any hidden talents that you can talk about on television?
It's either parking in tight spots, which I'm quite good at, or I... I'm quite good at dressing and undressing in a car. I'm very good at it.
Because of the interest in dogging?
Because I used to go rowing quite a lot, and then you get very wet, and you need to change out of your wet gear, and...
I'm sorry, can you hear what you're saying?
But it's very easy, and you can do it very cleanly and decently, and no-one can see, in a car park.
Have you ever seen anyone do it badly? I'm really
good
bad
point.
At getting changed in a car. Yeah, an arse on a windscreen.
Susie has appeared on Countdown over 2,000 times. Just imagine all the exciting stories she's got. Well, you'll have to, because she hasn't got any. Susie, you've recently done a show all about the history of swearing. What is the oldest swear word?
The oldest one is shit.
How old is shit?
Shit is Old English, so over a millennium old.
Over a millennium?
Yeah, and it's so always like... meant poo, always. But my favourite one is bollocks. Because that was completely neutral. So, in the army, for example, they were told not to say kiss my arse, but kiss my bollocks. It was absolutely fine. And it was a term of affection. So you would say, my little prick, my pretty pringcock, my sweet bollock stones, which were your testicles, basically. Oh. So I think that's quite cute.
I'm sorry, I can't tell whether you're telling a sort of story about the origins of phrases and words, or we're flirting.
I could call you my little bollocks from now on.
Well, they're not massive, but they get the job done. Susie Dent's written 14 books all about the meanings of words and phrases. She's like the J.K. Rowling of lexicography if J.K. Rowling had written 14 boring books that no-one wanted to read. OK, you've been working on a book about the differences between men and women when it comes to language. What have you found out?
Hoping to write it with Jo Brand. So, Jo being Jo, she's got me looking at various things, including penises. In English, and there are about 1,300 slang terms for the penis. Quite a lot of them. I think it's something like 500 big ones. And they're weirdly specific as well, so size has always mattered. So, in, I think, around the 1700, there was something called a rantalion, which is a name for a man, but it was also based on someone whose scrotum is longer than their penis. And it's described as the shop bag is longer than their pouch.
Susie has been on Countdown for 24 years, and her fame means she's often recognised, whether it's at a gangbang, a sex dungeon... or at a notorious dogging hotspot. People are often saying, look, it's her off telly. Susie, you carry a notebook wherever you go so you can write down new phrases you come across. What was the last thing you wrote down?
Malaphor. Have you heard of malaphors?
Malaphors, no. What's a malaphor?
Between a malapropism and a metaphor.
Oh, okay.
For example, the early bird is worth two in the bush. or he's got a chip up his ass, or that's a hard nut to swallow, that kind of thing. It's when you mix two expressions together.
It's a hard nut to swallow.
Yeah. I've got one of those, I think. My mum once said something was difficult, and she said, oh, it's like shitting in the wind.
Susie likes her books like she likes her men, lined up next to each other and preferably covered in leather. Susie, you recently reached your 25th anniversary of being on Countdown. How did you celebrate?
I got a whole lot of lovely Arsene Wenger stuff. So I got a signed photograph, a special letter. I know I'm the only person in the world that would appreciate this. But it was a complete surprise. I had absolutely no idea. And it almost came out, but Rachel stopped one particular person.
Right before lunch, before we filmed her 25th anniversary special, one of these contestants came over and started congratulating her. And I just wanted to make it stop. So I gave him, you know, the look that just says, shut up now. And
he kept... I know that look.
But he kept talking, and it was just me, him and Susie. So all I could do in a panic was stood in between them and went, fuck off! And just hope that Susie wouldn't notice. And she didn't.
I didn't.
Hanging out with Susie Dent is a laugh a minute. Unfortunately, those minutes are spread out over several years. Susie, we've got some very talented musicians on the show this evening. Are there any interesting musical words that you could tell us about?
Well, I interviewed some classical musicians. They told me things like red mist.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, mm. Wind instruments. Red, when you blow so hard that you just... You'll know all about this, Jimmy, in fact.
when you blow so hard, what happens?
You run out of oxygen. The worst thing that can happen. And the pearlies, which are moments of extreme fear. Like if you accidentally get a note in when it is supposed to be silent, that's the pearlies. Right. Have you heard that? The pearlies?
Yeah, they've heard of it. They've heard of it.
Susie Dent has written 14 books on the English language, and they're a very erudite way of lighting a barbecue. Susie, you wrote a book about the secret languages used by people in different jobs. Have you got any you could share with us this evening?
Oh, Joe helped me with the comic section, didn't you? Comedian section. And you were, actually, comedians were really clean in their language, at least according to Joe. But a lot of people weren't. So roadies, for example, can be quite filthy. Sound engineers can be quite filthy. So for both of them, you have a male plug and a female plug. And the male plug has pins and the female plug has sockets or holes. So they call... it's a socket with two female, you know, things, and one male pin, and they call that an LB, a lucky bastard. And if there are three females and one male, then it's a VLB, a very lucky bastard.
Filth. Susie has written 14 books on lexicography, and if you've ever wondered what it must be like to be a polar bear in a zoo, rocking back and forth in a tiny cage as you dream of the sweet release of death, you should read one.
That's so rude. I'm so used to it.
Susie, you wrote a book about the secret languages used by people in different jobs. Have you got any that you could share with us this evening?
Well, yes, it was about the secret languages of different people, so tribe talk, really. And butchers were quite cool, because a lot of butchers in pockets of Britain speak backslang. Not only is things spelt backwards, but they throw consonants in and things. So they swear in backslang, so tish is shit. And k-fuff-foo, I think it is fuck off. And they just learn all these amazing sentences just to impress each other. Who traffed? Who farted? And this is all going on in butchers up and down the land.
Perhaps if they spent less time doing that and more time opening after 1 o'clock on a Saturday, I'd get some
Good point.
OK, and enjoy...